Draft champions. This is taken at the three. And not a bad return here. He gets it out to the 25-yard line. And the coach has decided to throw the red flag. He will challenge this play. Well, he challenged the play. It did not pay off.
And that means he lost a timeout in that challenge.
And as a coach, you hate that. Don't know if you took the advice of the player. You threw it yourself, but it didn't go your way.
At the end of the day, it all comes back to the head coach. He has the final determination on whether to actually challenge the play or not. In this case, it didn't pay off for him.
And that's got to be so heartbreaking. You throw that flag, you probably feel really confident, and then all of a sudden, boom, you lose the challenge.
Yeah, when you take a look at it, you're throwing that flag because you believe you're going to be right. And when it comes back the other way, you have to regroup.
Mariota now from the 50, escaping the pressure right. And it's incomplete. It's a dangerous pass. That's what it was. And it brings up second down.
Pretty nice coverage there, but a missed opportunity for an interception. Let's face it, a lot of these defenders, they've got it all. Speed, athleticism, hands, a little bit questionable.
And he'll be taken down at the 44-yard line. It's a gain of 6 on the play, and they're going to face a third down.
Well, he did a nice job keeping his eyes downfield, waiting for someone to get open. But once the pressure forced his eyes down to see the rush, it was time to make a break for it.
Now Mariota, flushed out right. He may try and run for this.
Can anyone get it?
What a move. And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25. So after that big gain, let's see what else the offense has up its sleeve.
On third and short, not only did he get away from the rush and pick up a first down, he picked up a whole lot more than that. And how did he get it done? Evaded the rush, kept his poise, and then how about him directing traffic as he moved downfield to pick up extra blockers? A really nice run.
Mariota, and he's going to be taken down here. A sack back at the 32. The seventh play now of this opening drive. This is third and long, though. Third and long here for Mariota. Flush to his right. And incomplete on the deep ball. He was looking for the connection with Devin Funchess. And it's fourth down.
We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away. But the bottom line is, that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
They'll need to get the playoff quickly. Now Mariota, eluding the pressure right. Looking for Funchess, but it's intercepted. Picked off by Champ Bailey. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. And Champ Bailey, a man who had 52 picks in his great career, has a pick there.
And if people had actually challenged him more, what do you think that number would have been?
Could have been higher. They just didn't like to throw his way in for good reason.
Well, when you throw it and he takes it away, and he had such great ability that when he made an interception, there's a potential it'd end up in the end zone. He played both ways in college at the University of Georgia.
And another example right there, Charles. McCoy is good getting the ball handed to him. He's also dangerous in the passing game.
You put him in space, and you've got trouble as a defense, and they organize that one very well because, you know, the screen game, when they're deceptive that way and they create that space for him, look out. He turned into a heck of a play.
So a first down and 5 for the offense. To throw his car. Forced out to his left. And it's complete to Jacob Tammy. And he is down deep into Seattle territory. They get 39 yards out of that one. And the Panthers are going to get a first down.
We're ready.
Into the red zone. It's Carr. And he's got it. Touchdown, Panthers. Jacob Tammy, from 13 yards out. And the Panthers are going to take a first quarter lead. And he is a reliable target. They like to get him involved. They got him involved there for the score.
And they showed he's a very good player. Remember, they can use him in certain positions, so many different spots, and he usually comes through for them.
And he is into the end zone to bump the lead up two more. After the touchdown, it's Dawson on to kick it away. On the return, this is Jaquizz Rodgers. And he'll take this across the 25. Couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. The Seattle now ready to march out of the field. Looked like they had something going last drive. Then the interception happened. Will they recover?
The memory they need to keep with them is that they did have something going. They were moving the ball on offense, had a nice sequence going. Don't worry about the other part. You can't get that back. Let's go back to what you were doing well before.
I thought you were going to say they need to have no memory, but remember the good part, forget the bad.
I like that even better.
It's a pickup of 16 there, and it'll lead to a new set of downs.
That's the type of play there that puts a defense in a stress. Marcus Mariota on the run. You don't know whether he's going to take it downfield or throw the footballs we just saw there. And boy, was he accurate with that one.
You know, the Oregon coaches offered him a scholarship without ever seeing him start a game because they saw him in camp. They saw plays like that. Offered him.
He didn't start very much in high school, but he started a lot once he got to Oregon. As tight ends go, he might not provide the super flashy plays very often, but he's pretty reliable. Usually an excellent target and normally catches what's thrown to him, but he didn't on that play.
Mariota, he's going to leave this for his running back. It's complete. 12 yards there as they move the chains.
Right, I'm going to show my age here a little bit. We used to talk about running backs catching the ball as safety valves. Nowadays, they're a big part of the passing offense.
Quit acting like you're so old. You're only 65. A nice pickup there of 11 yards, and it'll move the sticks.
It appears they found something that's working, and they keep going back to it. I guess you can actually say he has the hot hands now, doesn't he?
Yeah, well, it's one thing to hit your guy out of the backfield once, hit him a couple times. Yeah, you're right. Maybe they're onto something.
And I think a lot of that is simply if you get it to him in space, more times than not, he's going to get more yardage than you expect out of each play.
Alongside my broadcast partner, Charles Davis, Brandon Gauden hits the Seahawks with a football to begin quarter number two, but they face a second and long to start things out. Mariota now on second down, escaping the pressure right. And complete on the right side to Bennett. A nice gain of 21 yards. So after that big play, let's see if they can catch their defense maybe on their heels. So the defense blitzed. A nice job picking that up, completing the pass.
How in sync was the quarterback in his center on that play? They saw the blitz, made the appropriate calls, got the line engaged because now they know there are going to be extra guys coming at the quarterback, so they got their assignments down pat and kept them away from him, and he's able to step up in the pocket and fire one now for a really good strike.
No gain that time on the completion, and it'll be third down.
And that's when it's fun to play defense, when you're able to diagnose a play right from the beginning, get all your guys to the football and spill the play. That's when you have a lot of fun playing on that side of the ball.
Can't find him. And down he goes. Pressure gets him back at the 14. Kendall Langford in there to drop him for a loss on the play. Well, this has been a pretty sizable drive. They've had some success. Finally, the defensive coordinator found some success of his own.
I think he just simply said enough of that. Okay, they've moved the ball well. We need to force the issue from our end, and that's exactly what he did.
Mariota now. End zone caught. Touchdown, Seattle. Martellus Bennett from 13 yards out. And the Seahawks a two-point conversion away from tying the game. Mariota will look to throw. It's complete. And he'll get into the end zone as the two-point conversion is successful. So a tie ball game. game here as the kick's away. Short, short kick. One of the up men will take it now. And they're able to return this one all the way up to the 45. The Panthers offense here, they get ready to head back on the field. And they were able to punch it in the end zone last time. They'll be looking to do that again here for the defense. Obviously, they'll be looking to stop them from punching it back in the end zone.
It always is punch counterpunch, isn't it?
He's got it for a Panther touchdown. Ty Montgomery, 54 yards. And the Panthers have taken the lead. Well, that didn't take long. The turnover instantly almost turning into points.
And when that happens, a lot of teams have the mentality of let's strike right now. You've got them off balance after the turnover or the takeaway. Let's go get it. And that's exactly what they did.
After the touchdown, it's Dawson on to kick it away. This will be fielded on the back line of the end zone. And the Seahawks get ready to trot out on the field. Now a play fake here on first down. They'll roll him out right. And that will be caught. But out of bounds. Out of bounds. Ruled incomplete here. And there we saw rolling right out of the pocket. Maybe his momentum taking him toward that sideline led him a little too far.
Yeah, that is difficult, isn't it? Plus, you're closing down your space, right? You're shortening the field for your receivers. And their inclination is to go towards the sidelines as fast as the quarterback is as well. Hard for them to throttle down to leave themselves with enough room to stay in bounds and catch the ball.
Flushed out right. And he'll get it up near the 35, right at the 34 here. It'll be a gain of 9, and that'll bring up a 3rd and 1. And the 2-minute warning lurking. This will probably be the last play before we hit it.
Yeah, they want to get themselves in position to score in this last shot before the clock hits.
2 minutes to go here in the first half. Back to Tennessee after this. They stay on the ground, but this time it's Elliott. Only a yard on the pickup there, and it's going to leave them with a 4th down. So in their own territory, but they only need a few inches, so they're going to opt to go for this thing. We'll see. Maybe a surprise pass or run. What will they do? We're about to find out. 4th down. It's an 8-yard pickup, and they're able to convert here on 4th and inches.
Wow. That one took some guts. If this doesn't work, you're handing them incredible field position, but this head coach is undaunted, and he makes the call to go for it, and I'll be darned if they don't get the 1st down.
Wildcat look. It's Elliott. And he takes this one down all the way near the 30. A good pick up there, 26 yards.
Outside handoff to the right side. If you're a running back, you love getting the ball early so you have vision to see what's happening in front of you.
Right tackle likes that call. Big play for him. But don't forget about the guys you always tell me on the backside seal. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have 2 remaining here before we get to halftime. See if they stay on the ground for 2nd down. They'll come up now in the Wildcat package. Here's a direct snap to Elliott. And a gadget package there won't do much for him. He'll get back to the line of scrimmage, and that's it. Randy Starks there to get him down.
Well, so many times we look at a short run, and we praise the offense for trying to set the tempo and establish things, but the defensive guys, hey, they just won the battle there. It wasn't a big run given up. They don't always have to absorb the body blow. Sometimes they dish them out themselves.
And he will have the first before he's brought down right on the chalk of the 20. And the 8th play on this drive coming up.
Now, that's the way to do it. Hand it to someone with vision and good footwork and add in a little bit of power, and you find a way to pick up 1st downs.
And eventually brought down, but it's near the 5 at the 6. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. And with halftime on the horizon, they'll be out of timeouts from here forward. And they'll get him down here at about the 5-yard line. He'll get two out of that run, and it's going to bring up a second and goal. Be interesting to see now what they do offensively down near the goal line after not much there that time.
As the offensive play caller, that may change your sequence now. Instead of coming right back with a running play, you may have to go to the air.
Oh, he fakes a spike. And just shy of the goal line as he's out of bounds right at the one. Give him three on the play, and that'll make it third and goal. Great footwork there, Charles, to dot the I, stay in bounds, get both feet in. He's probably thinking, though, man, I made a catch like that close to the end zone. I should have scored.
It was always a regret.
And he will take this one in for the Seattle touchdown. Marcus Mariota in the final seconds of the first half. And the Seahawks are now just an extra point away from moving out in front. They'll look to throw. This will be caught at about the 5. And he is into the end zone. So they get two more on the board here just before halftime. The kick unit for the Seahawks out there on the field. And we are ready to rock. So a very short kick here. This will be taken by one of the up men. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. Here are the Panthers now as their offense comes back out onto the field. And from this spot in the field with the clock where it's at, you think we're just going to see a knee and that's it?
And I think in this situation, that's the proper play. But we do know there's some risk takers out there that may want to take one more shot before the clock runs out.
So we have reached halftime here in a tight two-point contest. As we'll send you down to Orlando, where Larry Ridley has our EA Sports Halftime Report. Larry? Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number 3. It's a very short kick taken by an up man. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. Out come the Panthers. They'll have it first on offense in the third quarter. They're down here, but very much in this game. What's the tonality of a coach's talk when a game is within striking distance like this at intermission?
Typically, what they're doing is emphasizing the things that went well in the first half and wanting more of that. Sure, you've got to go over some of the errors and clean up some things because there's a reason we're down. But overall, I think they want to stay positive, stay up with this team. We're just starting the second half.
He's got it at the 15. And he is down deep into Seattle territory. And at this stage, down in the second half, looks like they just wanted to find a way to get it in the hands of their playmaker, and they did.
I think you're exactly right. I don't think the coordinator's looking at his play sheet and trying to figure out which play will work well. He's trying to figure out how to get the ball to the playmaker that you just described. Looking down at that sheet, you find people plays, not necessarily X's and O's, and that's exactly what they did there.
And he'll be brought down here at the 3-yard line. 4 yards on the play, and that leads to the first and goal.
So many teams want to throw the ball in this situation nowadays, but I love watching a team that has enough confidence to go ahead and run the football in that situation. That's almost a tendency breaker.
Oh, he tried to pitch it, and the ball's loose. And the Seahawks have picked it up.
But give some credit to the defense. They forced the big play, knocked the ball free from him, but it's a cardinal sin by the quarterback. Know where you are on the field, and he just gave up at a minimum 3 points.
And instead of getting down, takes the contact. The turnover ensues. Mariota now after the fumble recovery. Flush to his right. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect. Second down now after the incompletion. Throwing again. Mariota on 2nd and 10. Looking for his running back, and he's got him. Give him 6 on the play, and that's going to bring up a 3rd down.
It's funny, throughout the time that we've been together, when we talk with running backs about the ability to catch the ball, their eyes light up when they talk about open field and having one-on-one matchups, don't they?
Yeah, they do. And that's the reason why. What we just saw, shedding those tackles, and that's what they're used to doing.
It is, and it starts at the beginning of the play, one-on-one matchup if someone's trying to cover them. But they also like those one-on-ones downfield after the catch when they're running with the ball. They think they're going to win those, too.
One receiver left, 2 to the right. A first down throw for Mariota. Funches with a catch over the middle. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down.
Well, if you do read man coverage, Brandon, the drag route's a pretty good one to run against it because you're running away from people on it.
Second down of the offense needing 5 yards. They'll come out in the pistol. They'll throw again. Mariota eluding the pressure right. And some room to work. And he's taken down, but not before he gets this into enemy territory across the 40.
Partner, it's often the man coverage is easier for a quarterback to run against. You get your receivers going downfield. Those guys are staying with them, and oftentimes they have their back to the quarterback, which opens up a lot of space and room, and they don't even know that he's taking off with it.
And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Paul Kruger in there to pick up his second sack now of the afternoon. Mariota now on second down, escaping the pressure right. And he'll get it down on the play to the 37. 7 yards on the play, and that'll make it third down. Now play number 7 of this drive, but it's a tough 3rd and 9.
Well, he's proven real effective running the football. No one open, don't force it. Just get what you can, and that's what he's done very well in this game.
Martellus Bennett, the intended receiver, and that brings up 4th down. And a tough ask here. They're going to go for it on 4th down and 9. Mariota to throw for it on 4. And he's going to be taken down. Pressure gets there back at the 39-yard line. Carolina getting set to take the field. And they'll be looking to atone for last time's mistake of fumbling inside the red zone. Certainly they don't want to do that again.
And so much emphasis placed on red zone offense. I mean, you have periods devoted in practice just for that because everyone knows how vital it is to put points on the board when you've entered that part of the field. And to come away with nothing, that's difficult for a team to handle.
And difficult, and now we'll see if they can make it less difficult on themselves on this drive. They give them a gain of 38.
What really hurts defenses on screen passes is that they eat up one of their levels right away. Because you know how most defenses are 3 levels, D-line, linebacker, secondary. But on a screen pass, you're inviting the defensive line to get past them, and then you throw the ball over their heads, and now there's just 2 levels left to try and stop big guys out in front of a guy running with the football.
First down carry here for McCoy. Looking to find a lane, but he can't. Reined in at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there. 2nd down. And they're going to hurry back to the line now. Now Carr surveying the field. He rifles one that's intercepted. A great read and it's picked off. And he's going to get this one to the 23-yard line. Seattle now ready to march out of the field. They had a great drive going last time. They were moving the ball, and then all of a sudden it just stalled out. So we'll see what they can do here, Charles.
And it's always easy to second guess when you don't get it on a 4th down try. But they had to like the feeling that they had going on offense. They want to continue to see if they can capture that again on this drive and maybe get in the same position.
Yeah, and that's, I mean, like I said, they were moving the football. It's not like they went 4 and out, so I don't think it's a deal where the offense doesn't have confidence.
No, I agree with you totally on that one. If anything, they may have gained more confidence. Okay, they stopped us once. That's all right. Let's keep moving it. Make them do it again.
Oh, incomplete. A turnover would have really helped there. Almost intercepted. Instead, it's just 2nd down. A 2nd down throw here for Mariota. Dancing to his left. And he'll be out of bounds after getting this one across the 40. It'll be a gain of 8 yards. And just like that, it's 3rd down.
I like his thought process and his ability to move and get downfield. But what I didn't like was the final decision to go out of bounds. They want to keep the clock moving. Instead, they give the defense an extra timeout.
Now Mariota being chased out left. And he's got the 1st down yardage as he brings this up to the 47. And the defense in desperate need of a stop. They have to get off the field and get the ball back to their offense if they want a chance. One man in the backfield, Elliott. Mariota now to throw on first down. He's going to hit his man out of the backfield. Complete. Give him 9 on the play, and that'll make it 2nd and short. And the offense here just looking to stay in bounds, complete the short passes, and put this game on ice. Now a 2nd down throw for Mariota. And complete on the right side to Bennett. A nice pick up there, 10 yards, and it'll move the sticks.
And that's why defensive coaches preach swarming to the football. It's usually going to take more than one guy to get that big man down.
And it did right there. Multiple broken tackles, but they eventually get him down. Flushed out right. Oh, no, he lost the football. But this will fortunately wind up out of bounds. Offense with a fumble, but they recover it, and it brings up 2nd down.
I don't know about you, but I could hear and feel the sigh of relief all the way up here in our booth.
That was palpable. The sideline, the friend there.
No doubt about it. Ball goes over the sideline, able to retain possession, no turnover. I know his coaches are screaming, just hang on to the ball, man.
Time for a break. We're back to see what happens after this.
And the Panthers bring in their nickel set as they try to defend here on 3rd down.
5 defensive backs. And he can't get a throw off. He's taken down. What a huge play at this point in the game. So 4th and 15, but the offense is staying out there to go for it. You never want to give up a sack. From the O-line's perspective, they hate it for several reasons, especially because they felt like they let little brother down back there in the pocket.
Oh, no doubt. They have a ton of pride, and they go into every job wanting to keep that guy clean. They want that uniform with no grass stains, no dirt, nothing on it. But it's really, really difficult. You're talking about some terrific athletes who are trying to put him on the ground.
They'll look to throw. On the move to his left. He's going to let it fly. And, oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Picked off by the safety, Reggie Nelson. The Seahawks offense now, they get ready to head back onto the field. 2-point gain. They have the football. Their defense was able to do their job. Now can the offense just hold on here, Charlie?
And they better, because after the job the defense did to give them the ball back with this lead, it's time for them to seal the deal and allow them to go to locker room with a victory.
They'll try to seal the deal. Here we go. Mariota here to throw. And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. Picked off by the former first-round pick, Kevin Johnson. Here's the Carolina offense as they get ready to take over here. And last time wasn't pretty. One play and an interception. We'll see if they can do better.
I want to see if they want to go ahead and throw the ball again now on this drive after what happened on the last one. Throw it on the first play. Give the quarterback some confidence.
See what happens. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a 2nd and 9.
And that's why you see a lot of teams that like to play 4-3 defense, especially against teams that run the ball really well. Because you count on your defensive front, the tackles and the ends, to eat up the blocking in the offensive line and keep that guy in the middle clean so he can roam through the football and make a tackle. In this case, he introduced himself and said, "Hello, my name is Mike."
They come out with one back and 3 tight ends. On 3rd down, Johnson. And on this one, he'll get. Now the Seahawks are going to take a timeout here on defense. It's just their first. They've got 2 more to use here in the final stages. So on 4th down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. And Dawson's kick is good. And the sideline celebrates as they have taken the lead in the final minute. All right, so time to reset here. It's a huge kick there, gives them the lead, but they've got to be careful that their celebrations aren't a little too premature.
You're exactly right about that, because there still is time for the other guys to run a few plays and get into field goal position. So this defense is going to need to come up with one final stop if they're going to get out of here with a victory.
He's back to throw. Throws left side complete to Brandon Marshall. And he's out of bounds, able to take this one up to the 35. Give him 10 yards on the pickup, and that'll bring up a 2nd and just about a few inches here. Back to throw. Flush to his right. And he'll just chuck this one up into row G. It's incomplete. To throw, and that will be incomplete with a clock down now to 30. seconds. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. One score down. Here we go. They're going to go for it here on fourth down. They'll run it with Elliott. And he will have a first down as they get him to the ground at the 37. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. That'll be their third and final stoppage here as we step aside. Eluding the pressure right. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And that will be incomplete. Four ticks left here on the clock.
One thing I know from experience is that when the deep ball is thrown and you're the defender, you've got to fight that little bit of panic that emerges. You've got to play the ball really well. It's a 50-50 jump ball play. And guess what? They took a shot.
And a big loss here as he's taken down. Well, we saw a close game that kept us on the edge of our seats down to that final whistle. And right before that final whistle, defense with one last exclamation mark there getting the sack to end it.
I love how you phrased it because we were waiting to see what would happen. Obviously, we thought something would happen downfield. Instead, it happens in the offensive backfield, and that's your ball game.
Chains. Ow.
Caught up in my put your head on backwards. Then scared off after engaging laughter about what just happened. Napkins get sent to mammies. Is that too graphic? Catch you in traffic. You sitting daffy like stealing candy. My ceiling's absent. My wheels are massive. My friends assassins. All of us. Our mothers queens and our women dancers. My rivers rapping. My fin is splashing. My gills are flapping. I bit some matches. Then sip some something and kiss the dragon.
I'm really rapping. No fingers snapping. Them. Package. Y'all slipping, my swag is dripping, so here's a napkin. What's really happening, verbal attacking them?
Boy, we've just gotten started here, and already these guys have been handed a really difficult decision to make. Somebody. Boy, the skills just leap out at you with this guy. He will be a very important part of this ball club. And there's a pick that'll certainly help. Maybe not an impact signing, but you're not going to hit a home run every round.
Shoulder, no shoulder shrugging.
Boy, you can't go wrong with anybody out of this group. Some tough choices coming up right about now. And there's a pick that does fill a hole, but I'm not sure that it's really going to be the one that improves the overall squad a tremendous amount. Oh, no need to worry about this guy. Just plug him right into the starting role, and he'll be a massive upgrade. And this team does have a lot of needs, but this guy is a legitimate star, and he'll make everyone around him better.
Pull on the scene and the queen playing past the truck. Ready, turkey, spaghetti, and castor oil. That's
tough call here. Do you try and get tougher up front? Or get yourself a player in what we call a skill position. And now's where you need to make these last picks count. Time to fill any holes you can before it's too late. This is a pretty telling pick here. Do you go for a big bruiser up front? Or get yourself someone who could be a difference maker at a skill position? And with time running short, you've got to hope some guys fall into your lap, or you could be left with some real holes on your roster. One thing's for sure in this round, you're going to walk away with a great player no matter which way you go. And now, which side of the football will they address here? Some interesting options either way.
Got a mansion, a condo.
We've seen a Houston Texan be taken already in the draft. I don't think you needed a crystal ball to see that pick coming. That's all about loyalty and familiarity right there.
I make a ticket and gather and calculate the data. I listen up for the snakes or the baby rattle. I play the shadows, don't play no games. I straight get at them. I'm on a
back all day, like it's my favorite album.
I play the sound when they came in islands. Dancer. If I don't get the car first, I have a temper tantrum. I'm innovative, I demonstrated this, played it. I don't care if you owe me it. You need to pay me. I kiss your lady, then kiss the baby. Get situated, get keys off table and leave her. I really made it, get it made. Won't wrestle, cause I spatula all you action figures.
These tiny like a spider on a spud web. I got some ass on my thumbnail. I feed it to my girls, they say, yeah.
I'm doing this for the L. When I go, I'ma leave for the bell. I told her you did like a chef. I want a Ferrari in yellow, just so I can match all my yellow. I've been a player since elementary. I got more bars than a penitentiary. I got a that hangs several inches.
I can make it bounce by myself. I can make it bounce.